Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Drew Anderson.
And already our temperatures are in the mid-80s this afternoon. It has been since last Thursday. That's the last time we saw numbers this high. We certainly have been treated to some great weather. That all starts changing today. Our dew points are also high. These numbers are in the 70s. A lot of moisture when you step outside. You instantly notice the humidity. But it's still bearable right now. Later this afternoon, as we approach our highs in the upper 80s and near 90, that's when you'll notice the humidity get uncomfortable and that great weather, comfortable weather we had the past few days, start to depart. So today, a mix of sun and clouds. We'll keep it humid, as I mentioned. And later this afternoon, we'll have a few strong, isolated thunderstorms. The concern there will be for some damaging winds. In the background of your News 8 Storm Team forecast, we have Lewistown today. Tonight, the showers and storms that we do have, the isolated ones, they'll be ending early. Otherwise, we'll have some patchy fog for the spots that do get those storms. Drop down to the upper 60s. And for tomorrow, spotty storms again. It'll be breezy. And late in the evening, that's when we'll turn less humid thanks to a cold front. Highs will still be in the upper 80s. Here's a live look over Harrisburg. A pretty picture. A mix of sun and clouds this afternoon. The temperature is 86. As I mentioned, dew point very high at 70. The farther we get from 50, the more uncomfortable it feels. And right now, it feels like 91. Later this afternoon is when we'll really notice the humidity crank up. And these dew points are high everywhere in the east. But notice out to the Midwest. These numbers are lower than us. Some of this less humid air arrives for tomorrow afternoon. And here's the big picture of what's happening this afternoon. We have some storms over the Midwest. This energy will primarily be diving down to our south, and that's where the bulk of the heavy rain will stay. But as it moves down to our south, it'll send just enough energy our way to bring a few storms, particularly after about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Here's a satellite radar image loop over the Susquehanna Valley over the last few hours, and notice how pretty much a clear picture. Just a few fair weather clouds in there, the storms staying out to our west. That's why it'll still be a few more hours before we see them. Now, the Storm Prediction Center, that's the group that issues our severe weather watch, has us under a threat for severe thunderstorms for later this afternoon. As I mentioned, the wind, the concern, the hail, not a big deal today at all. So, predictor, let's keep an eye out for when the storms do arrive. After 2 o'clock, here's about 3 in the afternoon, 3:30 to be exact. A few spots with storms, like on the county line between York and Lancaster, one by Dolphin County and Harrisburg, one diving to the south of Adams County. The storms will be wrapping up after about 8 o'clock as they start exiting the Susquehanna Valley, and everything will be out of here as we head toward later hours, like about 12 in the morning for Tuesday. After that, we have a cold front that'll be poised to arrive early in the day on Tuesday. Usually, our cold fronts arrive later in the day. Here's some clouds right ahead of that cold front, and as I advance predictor into later Tuesday afternoon. Here's about this time tomorrow, about 1 o'clock. Notice how we have a few showers and storms, so that cold front passes. But then for late in the evening, we'll get some sunlight and some of that less humid air. So temperatures today quite warm, as the humidity certainly has returned. Later tomorrow afternoon, that's when we'll lose the humidity behind that cold front. Very seasonal Wednesday, 84 degrees, humidity not a factor. 88 for Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Some active weather. We'll have showers and thunderstorms in the forecast for all those days. Now it's looking like Sunday is dry and dry into next week, but we'll keep an eye on that because it's pretty hard to predict the weather for the next few days just because there's really no distinctive weather pattern. It's one of those weeks where we're scratching our head a little bit.
Yeah, but it looks like Wednesday is the best day of the week.
That's for sure.
Perfect Wednesday. All right, thank you, Drew.